Hi, today we're going to show you how to work with a model that contains multiple layers or surfaces. This is really nice for the visualization in the panel because we can show the real road layer buildup on the panel itself. What is important is that we are working on the right layer or the right surface. So let's get inside the machine and have a look at how we select that. The machine behind us we have is an excavator, but this works the same for dozer and grader. So let's shift to the panel. We can see here on the panel that this model has multiple layers or surfaces. Firstly, we just want to confirm that we have the right model selected and visualized and also referenced. Now that we're back in the run screen, our task is to work on the sub-base layer. So with a press and hold on the run screen, we can then go in and select sub-base. Now that we're back in the run screen, we can see that our height references have changed to that specific layer, and this is the sub-base layer. We could continue to work on this if this was the desired layer that we wanted to cut, but in this situation, this layer is a fill, which means that we need to add a compaction value of 100 millimeters to this layer. This is how I do that. I go into my offsets menu, I click on offsets, I select 100 millimeters, back to the run screen, and now you can see that I have my desired offset in place. The original value is the light green layer, and the target that we are now going for is the dark green. So we can see that our values in the cut fill have now changed to represent that surface. It's easy enough to remove that offset also by going back into the offsets. We click on the cross, which removes the offset. And there we go. We're back to the original sub-base surface. And the cut fills are representing that sub-base surface. That's it. In this video, you've now learned how to work with models that contain multiple surfaces and how to offset those surfaces. Thanks for watching.